Hey everyone, welcome to Apigee 4-Minute Videos for Developers, Season 25, Episode 4. In this video, we're going to discuss about how we can able to categorize the cache data so that we can better manage the cache data in Apigee Edge platform. Myself, Anil Sagar, I work at Google and Apigee platform. Prerequisites for this video, you need to understand the basics of API caching. For that, you can refer earlier 4-Minute Videos. Let's understand how we can able to group the cache data into different categories and better manage them in Apigee Edge API management platform. As you know, Apigee Edge sits in between the client and target system where you can able to proxy the APIs and enable the caching on the need basis so that whenever a request comes to Apigee Edge platform, once the data is cached, Apigee can able to return the data directly from the Apigee Edge platform without going all the way to the backend system. Most of the times, you will have different proxies and different kinds of data that you want to categorize so that you can able to better manage the cache data. For example, you want to flush the cache data that is stored in a particular category all at once, or you want to set different expiry times for different cache data. You can able to do that by creating cache resources in Apigee Edge platform. Let's see how to create this cache resource and categorize the cache data to better manage it in Apigee Edge API management platform. We're going to create a simple API proxy to demonstrate the cache resources and the API caching. Click on proxies once you log in into Apigee Edge platform. Click on plus proxy to create a new proxy. Choose reverse proxy, click on next. We're going to create a simple proxy called Books API, and we're going to use the Google Books endpoint to demonstrate the cache resources. Click on next, choose pass-through. Click on next, choose defaults, build and deploy the API proxy. Once API proxy is created, click on the proxy and click on the develop screen to attach the response cache policy. Click on develop. Let's attach the response cache policy. Click on preflow, click on plus step, add the response cache policy. As you can see, by default, there is no cache resource. That means everything is stored in the shared cache. Let's say you're creating two APIs, books APIs and weather API, and storing the data in the cache, then everything is stored in the shared cache. If you want to manage, let's say you would like to flush all the stored cache data of the books API responses, then since everything is stored in the shared cache, you might not be able to do that. That's the reason we're going to use the cache resources. Let's first create a cache resource for the books API, save the API proxy. To create a cache resource, click on admin, open the environments, and then click on the cache tab. Cache resources are per an environment, so you make sure you create the cache resource in both the environment station prod. So I'm going to click on test and then create a new cache resource. So let's say books API and give the expiration time for the cache resource. You can also create multiple cache resources. Let's say if I am having weather API, then I would like to store all the weather API responses in the weather API cache. Save the cache resources and we're going to go back and update the cache resource in the response cache policy. So we're going to define cache resource in the policy, and we're going to pick the name books API and give it to the policy so that all the books related API response data is stored in the cache resource books API. Save the API proxy. Let's start the trace session and see it in action. So I'm going to make an API call with queues equal to Node.js related books. Let's say I make an API call, first request goes all the way to the backend, and if I make a second API call, then it will return from the cache data where cache data is stored in our books API cache resource. As you can see, it took around 20 milliseconds. The advantage of having different cache resources is, let's say I want to clear all the books API cache data. I can come here, I can just say clear. And once it is cleared, let's say you go back and make one more API call, the request goes all the way to the backend since we cleared all the books related API cache data. As you can see here, it's going again to the backend. That's the advantage of having cache resources. Thank you for watching this video. If you are evaluating Apigee, you can reach out to us using this link. If you have any questions, please feel free to post your questions in community.apigee.com. Please spread the love for APIs by sharing this video with your friends and colleagues, and subscribe to YouTube channel to get notified if any future videos.